Welcome back to Blackwatch Intel. My name is Crashy, and today I want to kind of real talk about the PTR notes and PTR changes that we're, you know, kind of experiencing and seeing go live yesterday. Basically, the Junkrat Mercy nerfs. And the reason I say I kind of want to real talk it, and that's why I have it in the description. Again, I'm still sick, sorry. I have the flu. I'm trying to get over it. It's pretty bad. But the reason I want to real talk this is because I am genuinely afraid of some of the opinions and things that I see out there. And when I think about the game and when I think about balance, it all makes, you know, pretty clear sense to me. And so I kind of want to just talk about balance a little bit. I want to talk about these changes, what I really think is going to happen, and explain why I think they're good and bad, and what's good, what's bad, etc., etc. So I think it's easier to start with Junkrat, because I think the Junkrat changes really don't change a whole lot. Now, the worry with the Junkrat change is that there's going to be some inconsistencies with mine, because it's going to be hard to tell when you throw the mine just exactly how much damage you're going to do, unless maybe it's something that can be very practiced, where you know the timing, you know the distance, you know the throw, and then you're always capable of getting around 90 to 120 with it. But if you take a shot and you hit an ally, or an enemy rather, and then you do like a 90 damage mine, you're gonna like leave that enemy with 10 HP if they're a 200 health target. And I'm kind of worried about that. That's not gonna be fun for Junkrat. You know, imagine hitting a soldier for 190 damage and then him dropping, you know, the heal under his feet and then spamming you down. I think that's gonna be really not that great. So I'm a little worried about the inconsistency that might happen with Junkrat. But at the same time, a part of me kind of feels like it's not going to change very much. Like, I kind of think he's going to be just the same, which is not necessarily a bad thing, because I do think this is still a way of pulling damage away from his kit, but maybe he'll still be good, and that's good, I think. I think it's kind of like stepping stones for Junkrat. Like, you can't nerf him too hard, because then he goes back to being literally useless. So I'm excited to see the progression of the changes for Junkrat. I think this is a good start. I think maybe they could have done something different and that would have worked better, but we'll see. Now, when talking about Mercy, and I've done some like Twitter conversations and Facebook group conversations, the opinion that people have, specifically Mercy players, is actually horrifying. Like, I see a lot of people that truly think that post these changes, Mercy is going to be useless. And I think a lot of the issue is that players don't find value in Valkyrie as an ultimate. They find value in Valkyrie with resurrections. And that's the problem. That's actually what objectively makes Mercy overpowered on live today. And so I kind of want to talk about value and balance a little bit in this part of the discussion, where I kind of compare some abilities, and a bit of this is arbitrary, a bit of this is maybe even opinionated, but I think it's got a pretty good understanding and base behind it. So the way that I view game balance for a game like Overwatch is not that every hero should be able to obtain the same amount of value. I don't think that's balance. I think that balance is that heroes can have different value, but it needs to be the way that they earn it and the difficulty that they earn that value that makes the game balanced. So Ana can have a grenade that is, you know, super easy to earn the value out of, whereas, and it has good value, whereas Mercy has a resurrect but needs to be much harder to obtain that value because the value is higher. And I would arguably say that Mercy's resurrect is one of the highest value normal abilities in the entire game, if not the most valuable normal ability in the entire game. Thus, and I say this all the time, it needs to be conditionally much harder to land. The condition for getting a resurrect off should not be free. That's the problem with Mercy. That's what makes her a must-have pick. And I've said this in the past, even if Mercy had one instant res, she would be a must-have pick. Because every fight with Valkyrie would be a 7v6 instead of a 6v6. And that is what makes her a must-have pick now. She gets two instant reses. So the issue with Mercy is undervaluing Valkyrie as an ultimate and thinking that she needs these instant reses to be useful. I don't think that's true. I think that Mercy still has insanely high potential because she can still get a res off, and you're lying to yourself if you think that you're not going to get a slow res off in the middle of a fight. Now, whether or not you're the Mercy player that goes for a very high risk, high reward res is up to you. You know, if you want to fly in the middle of a team fight and press your res button and see if you get it off, that's your call. That does not make Mercy useless if you die. Now, here's the part about balance that I kind of want to touch on. A hero's potential and the value potential that these characters have is not and will not and never will be correlated to player skill. And this is a problem. I see a lot of arguments where people say, oh, well, if Mercy's such a problem, kill her. Or, oh, if such and such hero is such a problem, just counterpick them. And that's not a good argument. And the reason I say that's not a good argument is because it doesn't solve the problem. If Mercy is objectively overpowered, then the only way to counter that is to also run a Mercy. And that, in itself, creates the must-pick problem. And the same goes for a hero like Junkrat. Sure, you can counterpick Junkrat, but that does not lower his mathematical potential. It does not lower his insane burst damage. And so that's kind of where balance lies in my mind. So, with these Mercy changes, if I'm honest, I think it's going to pull her playtime back a lot. A lot. And I think that's good. I think it's fine. I think it's a really good change. I don't think that a hero like Mercy should be at the top of meta. But at the same time, I don't think that she is going to be useless. And I would arguably say that she might go down to being one of the weaker healers. But at the same time, in my mind, the way that the support roster works in Overwatch right now is that a lot of the healers have different usages. And so I would like to see, and I hope to see, and I think this is what will happen. I think Mercy is going to carve into a niche, like Lucio is carved into a niche, and like Moira will soon be carved into a niche. I think you will start seeing healing pairings based on team comp more. If you're going to run dive comp, you run Zen Lucio, maybe, or Lucio Ana. If you want to run death ball, maybe you run Mercy Moira. If you want to run some, I don't know, weird fast comp, I don't know, you know what I mean? I think there is going to be much more diversity with healers. And so I think these changes are good. And I think what people need to understand most, and the reason I wanted to make this a real talk discussion, and again, I have to reiterate on this, is that a player's ability to play a hero well and a player's ability to counterpick is not correlated to balance, and it never will be. Just because you're bad or you're good at a hero doesn't mean you can just counter the enemy hero. That's not how balance works. You can counter, you can kill the hero, but that hero still has that kind of kinetic potential, and that is what makes heroes objectively overpowered. So hopefully this discussion is somewhat eye-opening. I'm probably going to have to touch on this more and more. It's something that I want people to really understand, or at least understand my perspective. I think it's pretty clear for me, you know, where I understand things or the way I understand things. And I think these changes are a really great step for balance, because a lot of the other heroes in Overwatch are very balanced. This, for me, could really fix, in air quotes, the game. So let me know in the comment section down below, what do you think? Do you kind of understand where I'm coming from? Thanks for checking out this video. Please do not leave without leaving a like and subscribe for future content. I appreciate it again, and I'll see you on the next video. Do you feel the earthquake? Do you feel the fire inside of me?